Good morning, students. Today we are going to look at virtual memory, the last topic of the memory management unit 5. In the previous topic we had discussed about cache memory, the reason behind the invention of cache memory, and how the cache memory helps to reduce the average memory access time and different types of mapping techniques. In cache memory we observed that we are doing data transfer from a slow main memory to a fast cache memory, a slow and big main memory to a fast and small cache memory. The similar thing is going to be done in this topic also, virtual memory. Okay, so there the two memories are cache memory and main memory. But here the two memories are auxiliary memory and physical memory or main memory. Main memory is also called as physical memory because that memory resides inside the computer. Auxiliary memory is considered to be secondary memory which resides outside the memory. For example, a pen drive, a CD, a DVD, all are secondary memories. They may or may not be connected to the computer. Okay, so they are auxiliary. Auxiliary means optional. Okay, so now what is this virtual memory? Virtual memory concept is, it is a concept used in some large computer systems that permit the user to construct programs as though a large memory space were available equal to the totality of auxiliary memory. That means this concept is created to encourage the users to construct programs of size bigger than the memory available in the computer, which is main memory. For example, in my laptop I have 4 GB RAM, but you all know Windows 10 is a software operating system whose size is greater than 4 GB, and there are many softwares whose sizes are greater than 4 GB. Still I can install those softwares and run them, for example MATLAB or Xilinx. Those softwares are more than 4 GB size, but still I can install them, I can run them. How it is possible? It is possible only because of this virtual memory concept. What happens in this virtual memory? The same thing that happened in cache memory. In cache memory, we bought part of the main memory program and kept in cache memory, and CPU is referring to cache memory with a 15-bit address. Let us take the same examples. Cache memory size is 512 memory locations, and main memory is having 32K memory locations, and auxiliary memory is having 1024K memory locations. So the CPU is referring to the main memory, referring to cache memory with 15-bit address, as if it is having 2 to the power of 15, that is 32K memory locations. But the fact is, the cache memory is having only 512 memory locations, which requires only 2 to the power of 9 bit address. Okay, that's what happened in cache memory. Okay, that is how we increase the speed, that is how we reduce the average memory access time to improve the speed. Okay, because the time required to access main memory is 5 to 10 times greater than time required to access the cache memory. Similarly, here the time required to access the auxiliary memory is far greater than the time required to access the main memory, because earlier the auxiliary memory was used to constructed with the help of magnetic memories. Okay, even today my laptop is having hard disk drive, which is a magnetic memory. So in order to access this magnetic memory, it takes lot of time. That data must be converted into electrical data. One more thing is that disk has to rotate. It is having mechanical rotational parts, and this read-write head has to reach the location sector track of that magnetic disk and then retrieve the data. So it takes a lot of time. So this is highly avoidable. So that is why this virtual memory concept is invented. So here portions, programs and data are generally stored in auxiliary memory, and portions of programs and data are brought and kept in main memory as and when they are needed. Okay, so just like in the previous concept, even though there are no 2^15 memory locations in cache memory, CPU used to give 15 bit address by it places 15 bit address in argument register, which we had seen in the previous topic. Similarly, in this topic, CPU generates a 20 bit address in this example, because we are assuming auxiliary memory of size 1024k memory locations. But actual size of our main memory or primary memory or physical memory is 32k memory locations. That means it needs only 15 bit address. But instead of generating 15 bit address, CPU will generate 20 bit address, and it will refer to the main memory. So this 15 bit address must be converted into 20 bit address. So that is what happens in this virtual memory. How it happens? It happens with the help of memory management hardware. Okay, let us look at it. This is the memory management hardware. The main thing in this memory management hardware is memory mapping table. Memory mapping table. This is the virtual address generated by the CPU, a 20 bit address, and it is kept in virtual address register. And this memory mapping table is like the mapping table of cache memory. It stores addresses and data. So this address is compared with these addresses, and when there is a match, the data will be fetched from the main memory and given to the CPU. And this hardware uses this memory mapping table, this memory buffer register, main memory address register. That means this 20 bit address is converted into 15 bit address. Okay, because the main memory is having only 2^15 memory locations, so it needs 15 bit address. So this is how this virtual memory concept works. Even though the CPU is generating 20 bit address, as the main memory is having only 2^15 memory locations, with the help of main memory mapping table and this hardware, that big address is converted into small address to get the referred data. So similar to cache memory organization, there might be a chance of getting hit or miss. So here the miss is called page fault. Here the miss is called page fault, because look at this diagram. So this is our auxiliary memory and this is the physical memory or main memory. Okay, so auxiliary memory of size 1024k memory locations, and memory physical memory of size 32k. So let us assume that this auxiliary memory is a book with 1024 pages, and each page is having 1k lines, that means 1024 lines, and this is a main memory or physical memory, which is a 32 page copy. Okay, so you can write any 32 pages from these 1024 pages into this copy purchased by you from a shop. Okay, using your pen, you can write 32 pages from this textbook, any 32 pages. Okay, so here page size is assumed to be 1k. So if you assume size greater than 1k, 2k, then the number of pages will be reduced. Only 5 tall pages will be there, and you can bring only 16 pages here. So if you want to further increase the page size, if it is 4k, then you can assume this textbook as 256 pages, and you can bring only 8 pages and keep here, because 8 × 4 = 32. Or if you increase the size, why are we increasing the size? Because if you increase the size, you can bring more part of a program, because the program is being executed. Obviously, you need to refer auxiliary memory. So, in order to reduce that referring to auxiliary memory, which is a very slow memory, we are trying to bring as much memory as possible, as much program as possible, and put it here. So, why can't we assume this auxiliary memory as 32 × 32 = 1024? So, 32 page book, and bring one page and keep it here, that one page equal to 32k. There is a drawback to it. There are advantages as well as disadvantages. The disadvantage is sometimes we need to go to some other memory location. While executing the main memory, we need to go to some other location to execute a subroutine. So in such cases, single page is not sufficient. Even though you bought the entire program, you need to go to auxiliary memory again to bring the subroutine program. So to avoid that drawback, we don't assume the auxiliary memory of pages size with main memory. We will definitely assume auxiliary memory with page size less than main memory, so that we could bring more than one page and keep it here. Okay, so that is how this virtual memory concept works, and in order to make this concept work, we need this hardware, this memory mapping table is very important. Okay, and this translation of AM address, auxiliary memory address, into physical memory address is called mapping, which was similar to our cache memory mapping. Conversion of main memory address into cache memory address. Mapping is nothing but translation of address from big address to small address. There 15 bit address to 9 bit address, here 20 bit address to 15 bit address. Okay. AM is huge, slow. The purpose of this concept is to reduce the average memory access time so that the speed of the processor will be increased, just like our cache memory concept. The difference is the memories. There we had dealt with two memories which are inside the computer. Cache memory is inside the computer, main memory is also inside the computer. Both are electronic memories. But here, one memory is inside the computer and the other memory is outside the computer. One memory is electronic memory, the other memory was magnetic memory. Nowadays, that auxiliary memory is also became electronic memory because of the advent of SSDs, solid state drives. Okay, so by the time this textbook was written, there were no SSDs. That's why the author assumes auxiliary memory is a huge slow memory, cheap memory. So let us forget about SSDs for a while and just talk about HDDs, DVDs. Okay, so we need to reduce this average memory access time as much as possible. That is the purpose of this virtual memory concept. Okay, we refer to pages, page frames. Okay, thank you.